Dear students, I am Dr. Kumar, Assistant Professor, Department of Zoology, Government First Aid College, Shira, Tumkur District. The topic of today's lecture is sandfly-borne diseases. In that, you need to study cutaneous leishmaniasis. So this comes under paper 4. That is insect vectors and diseases, BSc 4th semester zoology, Tumkur University. What is cutaneous leishmaniasis? Cutaneous leishmaniasis is the most common form of leishmaniasis affecting human beings. It is a skin infection caused by a single-celled parasite that is transmitted by the bite of phlebotomine sandfly. There are about 20 different species of leishmania that may cause cutaneous leishmaniasis. In the image you can see how the skin is being affected, what is called as skin lesions, okay, skin patches, and that appears like a leprosy. A man with cutaneous leishmaniasis in the Middle East region. This slide also shows the skin lesions that appears like a leprosy, which closely resembles with that of the leprosy. It is the skin infection caused by a protozoan Leishmania donovani. Or the other the species, that is Leishmania tropica. This slide shows the vector, that is the phlebotomine sandfly, which acts as a vector in transmitting the disease-causing agent, that is Leishmania tropica. The parasite causing the Leishmania, cutaneous leishmaniasis, is Leishmania tropica. Cunningham, the scientist by name Cunningham, in 1885, first discovered this parasite. Later on, Borowski in 1898 and Wright in the year 1903, both of them gave an accurate description and morphology of this parasite. It was Luhi in 1906 who gave the name Leishmania tropica, which causes cutaneous leishmaniasis. As far as the geographical distribution is concerned, this parasite is found along the shores of Mediterranean region through Syria, Arabia, Mesopotamia, Persia to Central Asia, and the drier parts of the central and western India, and also in many places of Central Africa. The habit of this parasite is concerned. It is inside the chlasmocytes of the skin. Okay, it is present inside the chlasmocytes of the skin. Chlasmocytes are referred as, so they are the phagocytic monocytes. Monocytes, basically they are the white blood cells. Okay, so this parasite present in the chlasmocytes, they are the phagocytic monocytes found in the wall of the blood vessels of the skin. As far as the morphology is concerned, it is the amastigote form, that is the parasite present in the body of the infected host, is called as the amastigote form, occurs in man, while the promastigote form is found in the cultures of the sand flies. Morphologically, this Leishmania tropica is indistinguishable from the Leishmania donovani. It is very much similar to that of the Leishmania donovani. There is no distinctive features, okay, and it is very much similar to that of Leishmania donovani. The life cycle and the reproduction, it is exactly same as that of Leishmania donovani, except the mastigote form, which resides in the large mononuclear cells of the skin, that is plasmocytes, and not in the viscera. This is the primary difference between the visceral leishmaniasis and cutaneous leishmaniasis. Cutaneous here refers to the skin, okay, outermost covering of the body, whereas visceral, that affects the internal organs like liver, spleen, etc. But here it affects only the outermost covering of the body, that is the skin. Okay, that too, these parasites residing in the specialized cells which are present in the inner lining of the blood vessels, that part is the plasmocytes. So plasmocytes, basically they are the mononuclear cells present in the skin and not in the viscera. The amastigote form in man and the promastigote form in the sandfly both divide by binary fission, asexual reproductive method, what is called as binary fission. The reservoirs of infection in endemic areas, the dog serves as the reservoirs of infection. In desert areas, that is the Central Asia gerbils, that is rodents, also serves as the main source of infection, like the mice, rat, squirrels, etc. They serves as the source of infection in Central Asia. In the endemic region where this virus breakdown occurs, the reservoirs are usually the dogs. The modes of transmission. The sand flies may play a very important role in transmitting this Leishmania trophica. They become readily infected by feeding upon the cases of the oriental sores. The oriental sores are nothing but the skin patches or the skin infections. The promastigote forms appear in the buccal cavity of the sand fly in about 3 weeks. Infection is transmitted to man by direct inoculation through the bite of sand fly. The species of sand fly responsible for transmission of disease, phlebotomus, in North Africa, Iraq, India, Persia, and Central Asia. Okay, so in all this region you can see the disease causing agent, that is Leishmania trophica, is very much present and transmission is being occurred. As far as the pathology is concerned, it is characterized by the chronic infective granuloma with fibrosis. In early stage, proliferation of monocytes and macrophages occurs in the reticuloendothelial system. Okay, it is an infective granuloma. Granuloma here refers, and it is followed by with the fibrosis, where the skin is being affected, infected by causing the lesions, that is the patches of the skin, the patches and the swelling of the skin. Okay, and what is the in early stages of proliferation, the monocytes which are present in the skin or the macrophages are being affected as a part of reticuloendothelial system. Symptoms involves the skin lesions, that is the skin infection, patches of the skin are formed by cutaneous leishmaniasis. The post Kala-Azar dermal leishmaniasis is a recurrence of Kala-Azar that may appear in the skin of affected individuals. They are characterized by hypopigmentation, that is the skin lesions such as macules, patches of the skin, papules, and also the nodules occurs. So sometimes these patches occurs in the faces also. That is what is called as the facial redness. Though any organism causing kala-azar can lead to post kala-azar, that is a dermal leishmaniasis, it is commonly associated with Leishmania donovani, which gives different disease patterns. In the Indian variant, nodules enlarge with time and form plaques, but rarely ulcerate. So in the Indian variants, where you can see the nodules, the patches of the skin appears on the skin, they go on enlarge. They go on enlarge in size and appears like a bubbles. So with the time and form, the plaques appears, but they rarely ulcerate. But nodules form the African variety often ulcerate as they progress. Histology demonstrates a mixture of chronic inflammatory cells. There can be macrophage or epithelioid granuloma can be noticed on the skin. Diagnosis involves demonstration of parasite by microscopy, in vitro culture, or the animal inoculation. So you can see there, you can diagnose this cutaneous leishmaniasis through by taking the blood or the body fluid of the infected person that can be examined under the microscope, where you can see the Leishmania tropica. Immunodiagnosis of the parasite antigen can also be one of the method. The detection of the parasite DNA in the tissue is also one of the method of diagnosis. As far as the clinical features are concerned, the lesion, that is the patches which appears on the skin, begins as arised nodules, that is the patches, the swellings. In many cases, it ulcerates. In many cases of cutaneous leishmaniasis, the ulcer will develop. Then ulcer is filled with granulation of the tissue. As far as the laboratory diagnosis is concerned, so this consists of microscopic examination of the sphere made from the material obtained by the puncture of the indurated edge of the sore and stained by Leishman's method. Amastigote form of the parasite will be found in large numbers inside the macrophage cells, that is the WBCs. Skin test can also be one of the method in order to detect the cutaneous leishmaniasis. The intracutaneous injection of leishmanin is a suspension of promastigotes of Leishmania tropica, gives a positive skin test in the cases of oriental sore. As far as the treatment is concerned, amphotericin B and ketoconazole are the alternative drugs. Aminocidin ointment gives a satisfactory result. Sodium stibogluconate alone or combination with rifampicin is used for the treatment up to 4 months in order to get rid of the skin lesions. So this is all about the cutaneous leishmaniasis. These are the reference material along with the links given. Dear students, this is the time of COVID-19 pandemic. and the second wave is being operating now. Take precautions, wash your hands frequently with soap and sanitizer, use face covering mask and maintain a physical distance of about 2 meters between the individuals. Stay home, stay safe, save lives. Thank you.